This is a great day in the history of the village of Burr Ridge because we now have our first freestanding police facility. Thank you. The police have been rendering excellent services to the residents of Burr Ridge in cramped quarters and in some cases without the right equipment.
We didn't have interview rooms. We didn't have interrogation rooms. Our detention facility in the old police department, the village hall, was out of date, out of compliance.
Welcome to the Burr Ridge Police Department. If you want to walk this way, we'll go through the front hallway here and we'll give you your tour. These two rooms are carbon copies of each other. They're soft interview rooms, what we would call. They're not a custody setting. They're not secure. They're not locked doors. They're not the people that we're interviewing in here. They're not in custody or anything like that. It's simply where we would interview people. This is the squad room. It's where every shift starts and ends. There's BOLOs, which is be on the lookout. Those are different surrounding agencies put out wanted posters or wanted vehicles or information on a crime pattern that's occurring. These are the evidence lockers. Anything that's sensitive, like DNA evidence or DUI kits for blood vials, urine vials, things like that that are taken from the hospital, they can be stored here. This is a refrigerated unit so that we can lock them in there and preserve those types of things. In this room, this is a more advanced evidence processing area. These here are what's called the fuming cabinet with processing fingerprints. There's a technique called fuming to where it's almost a like a super glue, and you put a little bit of the super glue in that container, and as it evaporates, those fumes will find a fingerprint on that item and will actually harden that fingerprint to where it can't be wiped off.
Everybody had different views about how big it should be and how expensive it should be and where it should be.
What is the best bang for the dollar? How much money are we going to spend? And what will best satisfy the needs of the police station?
Every town has its own look. So this was designed to complement the village hall, be on a campus, you know, municipal buildings.
When we saw this particular plan, unanimously, the members of the Space Needs Committee as well as the board said it's a winner.
We now have this campus feel here with the village, with the Veterans Memorial, the administration building, and the police department.
You'll remember the soft interview rooms, yeah, that you saw earlier that were much more inviting, much more warm. This is obviously has a purpose, a single purpose. The chairs and the table are bolted to the floor. There's surveillance right here. There's nothing else to distract from what we're doing in here. We're questioning people who are suspects, who are usually under arrest or in custody. This is the lockup facility. This is an area where an officer can interview someone. It's similar to that interrogation room, only it's definitely a secure setting here. Also, there's that two-way glass that you saw in the hallway to where there could be a visitation, there could be consultation with an attorney, things like that. These are the male cells on this side, folks. Mattress, toilet, sink, and a mirror and the surveillance camera. Moving in here, this is a processing area. This desk here is where the officer is going to be entering data in for the processing report. A breathalyzer machine is there on the desk there. Gray machine. That's for our DUIs. Straight ahead, those cage cells that you see, those are like bullpen style rooms to where it's like a temporary detention.
One goal was to have a nice lobby area when people visit, because it's not just law enforcement training that's going to be going on in the training room. There's going to be homeowners associations meeting in there. We want the citizens to use the facility as much as they could.
This is also, I think, going to be a monument to the commitment that this village and its residents have to keeping Burr Ridge a very special place.